So, we're going to be looking at why Michael Burry decided to invest in water. Now, to begin this discussion, we're going to need to know some background information about the water on Earth and where we get our clean, accessible water from. 97% of the drinking of the water in the Earth is salt water, which we cannot drink. That leaves about 2.5% as fresh water. However, only 1% of this fresh water is accessible clean water, as the other percent is inside glaciers and is frozen, unobtainable. To understand how we use our fresh water that we can drink, we have to look at the water cycle. How this works is, still water, such as water inside lakes and streams, is fresh, and it evaporates due to the sun and into clouds, which is known as condensation. From these clouds, it releases as rain, hail, sleet, or snow as precipitation and falls back into the earth. It runs down mountains, such as, you know, as shown in runoff, and lands onto the earth's surface known as groundwater. This groundwater then is absorbed by trees and fed back into lakes and streams, which then transpire and evaporate back to the clouds and repeats the cycle, which is known as the water cycle. There are two different types of water that we obtain. One is groundwater, which is the water that after precipitation lands on the earth's surface and then goes underground and seeps into the soil. We can claim this water by using wells and aquifers, which are natural caches of water under the ground. As you can see, under the stone, there's a layer of water that we can use wells as like a large straw, almost, to have access to this water. In the United States, 25% of the water that we obtain is done through groundwater, and it's typically obtained in rural areas. Surface water is water that is sitting still, such as lakes, streams, and ponds and springs. This fresh water is collected and then purified through purification stations throughout the United States, and then is delivered into towns and cities through pipelines and wells. This accounts for 75% of the water that we drink inside of the United States and use. Now, looking at the world water usage, you can see that agriculture has a huge part inside of water usage. For example, irrigation is important for growing crops such as wheat, barley, anything like that, as well as feeding animals. So a lot of the water in the world is used for that purpose. The next largest is through industry use, such as generating energy for towns and cities and electricity. That's at 20%, and 10% is of domestic use, which is the household usage of water for baths, cooking, and anything of that sort. Now, looking at a global scale, we can see that the 2017 world population is 7.6 billion people. By 2025, this population is expected to rise 8.1 billion. Now, here's where we have a problem, is because the amount of water from the water cycle, we know how the natural process allows us to have a certain amount. If we have an influx of people, and this is large for only 8 years, we're gonna have a scarcity of water within the world on top of the scarcity we're already seeing today. 783 million people do not have access to clean water worldwide. That's twice the United States population. 319 million people in sub-Saharan Africa do not have access to clean water. So the whole continent of Africa, as shown, is scarce of water in total. 1 billion more people by 2025 will need a trillion more cubic meters of water for agriculture. This shows a higher demand for a commodity that we cannot produce on our own. It's up to the water cycle and natural occurrences to get our water. By 2050, 19%, there's gonna be a 19% increase in the agro water consumption, which means this already bloated number of percent that we need of water for agriculture is gonna raise even higher, thus showing that we're gonna need a new source of water or find new sources of water. Now, this asks the question of about investing in water and how might you do so and what could be the benefits. Water is known as a scarce commodity. Investing in water is similar to investing in gold or any other valuable item through exchange-traded funds. What you do with these exchange-traded funds is you invest in companies, and these companies create products, build infrastructure, and purify and conserve water. These companies are all related to water, but you do not actually purchase the water or purchase the stake in any water. You are betting that these companies will have amazing business and that your stock, and that the stock you buy is gonna go into the company to further their progress in business. Once that happens, you as a consumer and a stockholder would receive monetary value for the work that they do because of the demand of water inside of the world. Now, for the simple answer of why Michael Burry invests in water, the answer is because of supply and demand. Simply put, the population is growing at a very rapid pace as the human growth is exponential. This is going to cause a huge demand in technology that can create more opportunities to purify water, to harvest water, and to conserve it. Because of this, these water companies are going to have a huge increase inside of their profits and in the business, thus allowing the investors of these businesses to gain financially. This is why Michael Burry invests in water, for financial gain.